Thanks for joining me. I'm going to be talking today about one of my favorite programs. I have a lot of them, but this one in particular is really great because it helps me stay organized. It helps me be able to capture all the ideas, all the information that I want to have at my fingertips no matter where I am. And so you've probably heard me talk about this program before. It's all about OneNote. And today I'm going to be showing you how you can handwrite in OneNote, but have best of both worlds. You can handwrite your stuff in OneNote, but yet still have it typed up if you want to have it more formal or present it in another document or share it with other people. And so handwriting is possible whether you're using the desktop computer or you're using your phone or you're using a tablet or an iPad. That's all what you can do with any of those devices within something like OneNote. So I'm going to show you some examples that are already set up for you. Just bear with me as I show you this example here. So yes, my handwriting isn't the best here, but you hopefully get the picture. It definitely probably looks better on paper, and this was a faster example. But you know, you can use things like an actual this one is a Surface pen that I used on my Surface. You may have a pen that you use for your iPad, or maybe you have, where's my other pen? You might have a pen that has that stylus tip at the tip of it. So you could use any of those things to handwrite, or you can just use your finger to write your notes if it's on a device like the Surface or the iPad or the phone, right? So this is an example. I'll just show you some of the scary handwriting I did. So this blue is what I handwrote on this tablet with this pen. And then the purple's with just writing with my fingers. And then the green is what I did with the pencil on the iPad. So just various different ways. Some of them a little bit neater than others. But let's just show you, now you all know how to write, or you know, you can print. These examples are just with me doing my handwriting. I suppose handwriting isn't the best because I know my daughter is telling me that she can't even read my handwriting, and maybe you would agree with her, but I didn't think, some days I'm messy, but I didn't think I was that messy all the time. So, but cursive or handwriting is maybe harder to read these days. So that might be another reason why you take your notes. And if you're like me, handwriting is faster for me to take notes in that way. And then I can convert them to typewritten text afterwards so that my daughter or anybody else that can't read my handwriting can then read those notes. Okay, so let's check this out. I'm going to go back to that first handwriting example. This one's a little bit shaky. My L for lot is not really connected, and you know, I'm not my handwriting isn't the most perfect here, but what we're going to do is we're going to see what OneNote thinks of this. We're going to ask OneNote to convert this to typewritten text. And so how we do that is I'm going to go to my draw ribbon at the top here, and then I'm going to go to get what's called the lasso. I want to lasso, put a circle around that handwriting. So I'm going to go to that lasso there, and then when I move my mouse over onto the area where the handwriting is, I get a little cursor with a plus sign because it wants me now to make a square or a lasso. I shouldn't say a square, a lasso around the writing. So I need to lasso this writing. Let's see if I can do it. Yeah, I think I got it. Okay, so I don't need that line, right? And so it's just taken all that writing and it has it now. And so I have a four-headed arrow there, so I could move this handwriting around if I wanted to. I could cut it and paste it somewhere else. In fact, if you wanted to just do your signature, this might be a great way for you to do it. You can just sign your name on one of these devices. Hopefully it looks similar enough to your real signature. And then you can save it as an image and or paste it into another program that you need a signature for, right? So you can just do a copy and paste it into your email program or paste it into a Word document. It's really seen as an image at this point. But what we want to do is we want to change this into text so other people can read it. So you probably know where I'm going by now. At the top of the screen here, it says ink to text. and that's the one I want. Now, I've had some of you or some people within this group have asked me about this particular feature and the iPad. And unfortunately, on the iPad, I don't have the ink to text option. I can handwrite all I want on the iPad, but I can't convert it to text or typewritten text. Now, this might be a feature that comes back. I mean, it was there a while back that Microsoft had it available, but for whatever reason, it's not there on the iPad anymore. And so maybe it'll come back. So just watch for your updates. Maybe it'll be there. Otherwise, you'll have to take that note that you have the handwriting in and go to your computer and open it up there so that you can convert it, okay? So I've got this highlighted here. Let's see how good it can read my handwriting. Ink to text, moment of truth. Do you handwrite hot of notes? Well, it's got some words right? Hot obviously is not right. A lot of notes. Lots, I should say lots of notes, right? So well, it's not too bad. Save me some typing. So just imagine that that's a whole page of typing and you've just handwriting, and you just converted it to typing. And yeah, you might have a few errors you got to fix up, but hey, it does it. It works, right? So then let's go to the next page. Let's see how good we do here. And I might move things around a bit. So I'm going to go and highlight, lasso my handwriting. Okay. And then I'm just going to move that away from everything else. Okay. So now you see it. And we're going to go ink to text. Writing on Surface tablet with a pen. Okay, so that one, it actually converted every word, which, yeah, that's awesome. Okay, and let's do it again. So there's the lasso, and let's highlight that, move it over a bit, and then do you take lots of notes? Yeah, it didn't like my U, so I have to fix that up. That's maybe I need to handwrite slower next time. But the point of this is I wanted you to know that, you know, whether you're on your phone or whether you're on an iPad or maybe the Surface, and you find it more convenient to handwrite your notes. And that's kind of what stops people from using this program. They're like, oh, Connie, I don't really want to use OneNote because, you know, I like my little notebook and I like handwriting in there. Yeah, and I know it's not quite the same feel, but you know, you could have a pen and you could have your Surface, or you could have the pen and you could have your iPad, and it's pretty close, and it gives you the ability to do all this. Plus, I mean, with OneNote is a part of Microsoft Teams. It's a part of, you know, I could have it on my OneDrive or on my SharePoint. It's something I can share with other people. I can send a OneNote notebook via email to somebody else, or I could share it with another group or one person or a group of people, and that could be just by itself, the OneNote notebook, or I could do it within Microsoft Teams. So it's got so many different usages. I'm in the midst of just helping some people out with some OneNote training right now, and there is so much you can do with this program. I just wanted to share with you one of the cool nuggets that might get you a little bit more excited about it, or let you try a few things out. Let's just show you one last little thing about in terms of drawing. So I'm in the drawing toolbar, by the way, and one of the other things that I think is kind of cool in the drawing toolbar is that you have a highlighter. And so let's say I'm going to go back to something. Maybe I just, no, that's not new. Where's Connie's example? Well, that could work. I just got to see what it's going to get it bigger, obviously, so you guys can see it. Okay, so that's just another example. So I'm going to go back to draw, and I want to show you the highlighter, because the highlighter is kind of cool. So again, on a paper notebook, we would write something down, and then we'd take our highlighter. Do I have a highlighter? Yeah, I have a highlighter here somewhere. Take my highlighter, and I would highlight my notes, you know, to make sure I got back to it later on. Well, same thing, of course, in here is available to you. So if I go and pick that highlighter, and I can pick what size highlighter I want. Now let's do that one, and what color I want. Aqua sounds good to me. And then I can just start highlighting. Now, you know, it's if I go crooked with my mouse, that's what's happening there. If I don't like it, I can certainly undo it, or I can take the eraser and erase it, right? but I have a highlighter so I can highlight stuff. So that's another thing within OneNote, is that you know all the things that you can do in a paper notebook, you really can do in here, plus so much more. So check it out if you haven't started using it yet. OneNote is a free download on your phone, on your iPad, on your computer. If you have Microsoft 365, then you already have it. So just open it up and start using it. And if you have Windows 10, it already comes with Windows 10 as well. So have fun with it, try it out, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.